Asian food in a while. So today we're gonna make some wonton soup. In a big ass bowl, we're gonna combine some minced shrimp, garlic, and green onions. And we're just gonna season that with soy sauce, sesame oil, oyster sauce, some grated ginger, and chill! Pause! Give that a really good mix, and that's pretty much it.
Okay, cool. Now it's time to wrap them.
Boom, circular dumpling wrappers.
A little bit of that shrimp gets put right in the middle. Fold it into a half moon shape, then connect the ends. And yeah, that's basically how I wrapped it.
Ooh,
oh yeah. My own mother was talking shit about my wrapping skills, so she took over. Anyways, once you're done wrapping, we are gonna start on our soup.
In a big ass pot, saute some garlic and ginger until it's fragrant,
and then proceed to add chicken broth and water. Once our broth achieves a boil, we're gonna throw in our veggies,
a little bit of miso paste,
and for the finale, toss in the wontons.
The thing is, the recipe says to cook for 2 minutes.
Huh? 2 minutes?
I'm cooking it for 10.
You can do whatever you want though, just add parsley!
I know you guys have heard about the George Floyd case, so please help out in whichever way that you can.
Once you make this, you'll never buy it again. Cut 2 eggplants long ways. Make crosses into the flesh. Salt them to let them sweat. And let them sweat for about half an hour. Dry them with a paper towel. Drizzle with some olive oil. Roast them face down in the oven. In the meantime, get some tahini. About 2 tablespoons. Squeeze in some lemon juice. A little pepper. And of course, some olive oil. A touch of water to help it soften. Mix it well. After an hour, they'll collapse like this. Flip them around. Oh yeah. With a spoon, scoop it out. Get your eggplant flesh and mash it with a fork. You want it to still have some texture. Now pour in the tahini. Grate some garlic with my teeny tiny grater. A touch of parsley, a couple pomegranates, and a quick splash of olive oil for good luck. And enjoy.
Today we're making Korean sweet pancakes filled with brown sugar and cinnamon. So mix the yeast in warm milk and pour it into the flour. Give everything a mix until it forms a dough and let it sit for about 1.5 hours. And so you're going to split it into about 16 equal pieces and work on the filling. So the filling is brown sugar, cinnamon, and chopped pecans. Okay, so now watch how I fill them. So put some of the sugar, sprinkle some nuts on top, and then seal it shut. So now it's time to fry them. So fry it on one side until golden brown and then flip it over. And this is my favorite part. You're gonna squish it down until it forms a pancake. And that's pretty much it. These are so addictive and so good when it's cold outside.
Okay, this is for these girls who are trying to get that rich though, okay? You're gonna be making chili paneer. That's how you really impress the in-laws, okay? Soy, ketchup, sriracha, honey, kashmiri mint, salt, mix it together, oil, onion, ginger, garlic, red bell pepper. Give it a stir. Throw your tofu or your paneer in there, okay? If you want to be a little healthier, some green chili, put your sauce in, give it a stir, get married.
Here's how to make Korean dalgona candy. So grab 2 tablespoons of sugar and heat it up on the stove until everything has dissolved and it becomes clear. Then you'll add a little bit of baking soda and mix it in until it starts to change color and become really foamy. So it should look something like this. So once that's ready, you can pour it down onto a baking sheet and flatten it until you're happy with the shape. And yeah. So then grab your cookie cutter and press whatever design you want onto it. Sorry, my hand's in the way. And you're done. It's super cute and super easy to make. This one broke.
Boy toy named Troy used to live in Detroit. Big dope dealing money, he was getting some coins. Was the shootouts with the Lord, but he lived in a palace. Bought me Alexander McQueen.
Alright, it was really stormy outside, so I made some brown sugar toast. Oh, listen to that sound. All you need is bread, butter, and brown sugar. So start by mixing the brown sugar and the butter together until it forms kind of like a spreadable paste, something like this. So you'll spread it on one side of the bread, something like this. Okay, so move to the pan and cook it on low heat. So you need to make sure it's low heat, otherwise it'll burn really fast. So you can see it's starting to caramelize, so you can spread the other side and flip it over. By the way, no one said this was going to be healthy. Oh, so good. Okay, so let it cool for at least 5 minutes, so it ends up crispy on the outside and soft on the inside.
1 cup of brown sugar, 1 cup of peanut butter, 1 large egg, 1 teaspoon of baking soda, 1/2 cup of chocolate chips. Mix it all together. Divide into 12 and place on a prepared baking sheet at 350 for 8 to 10 minutes.
Ever been gifted a shitbottle of wine? Here's how not to let it go to waste.
Cafe style avocado toast, let's go. Deseed two avocados and add the flesh into a bowl. Finally dice a handful of parsley and add to the bowl along with some lemon juice, salt and pepper and mash to combine. Toast and butter two slices of sourdough. Add to your serving plate and pile on that smashed avo. Garnish with feta and herbs and top with a softly poached egg and a drizzle of olive oil. And there you have at home cafe style avocado toast. Enjoy.
This is one of the easiest curries you can make. Effort to flavour ratio is unbelievable. Yogurt, chilli powder, half a lime, salt, a little knob of ginger, a little bit of garlic. That's your marinade for the chicken done. So all you got to do now is cut the chicken into nice chunks. Leave that to marinate for a couple of hours. Now get on with the sauce. So you need another big chunk of ginger, about 4 or 5 cloves of garlic, chilli powder, ground coriander, turmeric, garam masala, cinnamon, fennel seed, coconut. Then in the pan, melted butter, get it foaming, ginger, garlic in, cook it out. One jar of passata, a little bit more seasoning, get in with your spice and your coconut, bring out the bowl with a little bit of water, lid on. Now we're going to make a paste out of pumpkin seeds and cashew, so in your pestle and mortar, get that working, then finish with a little bit of cream. Once that's come to the boil and cooked out, add that to your sauce, get a lid on it, let it rest. Barbecue your meat, get some good lines on it. Once you have, drop it in to cook it out. To finish, go with coriander, and I just go with rice. I love a bit of peas in my rice. Rice on the bottom, curry on the top, that's my buttered chicken.
All-purpose flour, 3/4 of a cup of sugar, 1/2 teaspoon of salt, 1 teaspoon of baking soda. Whiskey business. Gonna need a bigger bowl. A separate bowl for ripe bananas. Mash them up till they look like this. Whiskey and 1/2 cup of melted butter, 2 teaspoons of vanilla extract, 1 egg plus 1 egg yolk. More whiskey business. Wet into the drum and mix till your batter looks like this.
9x5 loaf pan.
Butter it up. Slippery. Add in your batter, smooth it out,
place in an oven, 350 Fahrenheit,
50 to 60 minutes, till the toothpick inserted comes out clean.
Out of the oven,
cool in the pan for a couple minutes.
Invert.
Ow, that's hot. Ooh. Cool completely on a wire rack. Look at this, it's perfect. A little slice for that good old banana bread.
Come on now, like, sheesh.
Pat of butter,
wait for that to melt.
Sheesh.
That's how you do it.
If you're feeling like a healthy snack, grab an apple, slice and dice, chuck it in a mug and fill with boiling water. Slide that bad boy into and out of the microwave. Add some cinnamon, some mixed spice, and some muesli of your choice, and add some ice cream if you have a sweet tooth.
Welcome back to Sunna Cooking with Sunna David, and today we are making chicken pho, which is basically like pho, but chicken. Okay, so first we're gonna go ahead and wash our chicken and then salt it and then stuff in some ginger and scallions into its body and pretend that this is completely normal and not barbaric at all. And then we're gonna drop it into the water, and I'm also gonna add in 4 additional drumsticks, one for each member in Blackpink. Unlike with beef or pork bones, we're not gonna dump the water out after boiling it, and instead we're gonna have to scoop the insecurities out manually, because you know what? You can't keep running away from your problems, because as adults, you should be able to talk it out with your partner. So like with beef pho, we're still gonna use the same spices. So star anise, cinnamon sticks, coriander seeds, and peppercorn. Except we're gonna use a little less because we want the flavor to be more subtle. Then quickly char some ginger and throw that shit in, and then an onion because it's cute. Then we'll season with some chicken powder, rock sugar, fish sauce, and salt based on how salty our ex was about to break up, even though it was completely their fault. Now let it all simmer for one BTS album and then take everything out, and you should have this nice clear broth that's at least twice as bright as your future, because I know mine looking real nice now without you, Amy. All right, and then we just put everything together, and that's it. Thanks for watching, guys. And Amy, if you're watching this, thanks for wasting my